we can't take a chance, you know, to get trucks being touched by unruly people.
Energy Minister Matthew Nkua says police escort of fuel tankers bring fuel in the country will continue until the police determine it is safe not to escort the fuel tankers. Mr. Nkua has disclosed fuel tankers are still not moving freely following the recent strike by some truck drivers on the Copper Belt. He states that government cannot therefore take any chance and risk the fuel tankers bringing fuel in the country being touched by unruly people.
So a lot of trucks have been parked and fearing to move. And we had a lot of trucks which were also on the border, Chanida and the Nakonde border. And to move trucks now when they are coming in, we are using police escort. So trucks are not still moving very freely. You can imagine we have to bunch up trucks, maybe 30, 40, and then get police escort. So that is causing a delay in itself. We have got enough fuel that is coming into the country, and we've got enough fuel in the country, but to move these fuel tankers now, we need the police escort.
And Mr. Nkua has advised truck drivers with concerns over their condition of service to use the right channels of having their challenges resolved.
First of all, I'd like to clarify the point that there was no strike. That we are just illegal, some people, some unruly people who are picketing, who are stopping truck drivers. They were in the bush, they were in Chingola, they were on the road and stoning trucks and so on. There was no dispute. There are three truck drivers associations, and all those associations never declared a dispute. And even today, if you speak to them, you'll find that they will tell you that they never declared a dispute and they don't have any problem. Moreover, all these trucks, they don't belong to the government. They belong to individual transporters. And if people are really looking for better conditions of service, they use the unions and go and talk about this.
Meanwhile, the Minister of Energy has ordered all filling stations in the country to stop selling fuel to customers who come with plastic containers to buy the commodity.
I can speak, for example, like in Chingola. They take a truck, immediately they get it there. A lot of people there, and the fuel finishes in no time because a lot of people have bought fuel in containers and so on, and also the motorists are panicky buying, and as a result they are causing this shortage. It's not helping the matter. If they can go back to the normal and buy the fuel in the normal way. And further, I would like to direct the filling stations to stop selling fuel in jerrycans, especially plastic jerrycans. There are special jerrycans that people are supposed to use for buying fuel, those steel jerrycans. Yes, if somebody comes with a steel jerrycan, they buy. But anybody coming with a plastic container, it's against the law to sell somebody fuel in a plastic container.
Mr. Nkua has also attributed part of the shortage of fuel in some parts of the country to panic buying. Lazarus Chula, Move TV News, Lusaka.